at Productronica 2015 at the Isola stand, I should say. It's not a booth, it's a massive stand. And Isola are specialists in PCB manufacturing, and specialism is materials. I'm talking with Alex, aka Alexander Ipich. Alex, huh? Alex, you are the specialist on PCB manufacturing from Isola.
Yes.
I see a huge number of different types. It's amazing. Can you give a broad outline of the at least the structure of your products? How are they structured, roughly?
Thanks for giving me the opportunity to show you a little bit about our materials. So what we have is in trying to break that up a little bit so it's not that many materials and it's kind of confusing people. We have one column here that's the halogen-free materials. There are a lot of people needing halogen-free or at least wanting it for environmental reasons. So we're offering all of that. Then we have here our, even if it's a little bit of short column, it's the main column. That's the high TG FF4 type of material. We have a 370HR, which is a product that's running for years and which is really a main product. The 185HR, which is basically improved and also cost improved version of a 370HR.
FR4 is the general family name.
Yeah, that stands for flame retardant. So that's a glass reinforced epoxy type of material. And a lot of people are using just FF4 as a generic term, even if they actually talk about high TG FF4, meaning it has a high temperature weight, it gets soft. Then we have here our what we call high speed digital line.
These are the most. Alex, are the different products?
The reason is that there are different needs in the industry. There's not one size fits all. People are very cost sensitive, so they don't want to spend money on a very high-end product if they don't need it.
Okay.
So we have basically separated it in the IS415, for example, is a kind of entry type of low-loss material. Very cost effective, has already a nice low dissipation factor, dielectric loss factor, but it's not the most lowest loss, but very cost effective. Then we have, for example, FF408HR, that's also a very long running product. That's kind of the standard in the low loss arena. Also has excellent reliability, and as you can see, the dissipation factor is already at 0.009. That's less than half of a standard FF4 type of loss. So that's already extremely improved. And then we just go up in even lower loss characteristics, like the iSpeed, which is the next step. And then we have the iTerra MT, which is really a interesting product because it has a loss value that's again only 1/3 of a 408HR, and it's actually capable of doing full multi-layer laminate constructions. We have all the prepregs, all the cores, so you can basically build any stack up you want with extremely low loss capabilities.
Yeah. Terra MT also has a brother in called RF MT in this line,
which is a microwave frequency.
Really microwave stuff. Now I'm a radio amateur. And I like this stuff very much.
So let me try to put it in a different separation. So that's the digital stuff.
Yeah.
Only zeros and ones.
Okay.
And this is the analog stuff.
Very fast too.
Yes. Frequency-wise, they are pretty much the same.
Yeah.
This may be a little bit higher, but it's pretty similar. But here we're talking about digital signals and here about analog signals. And you're right, these are kind of brother sister materials. This one is available only as cores. This is available as cores and prepregs. This is available at different dedicated decay values. So if you change the core thickness, you still have the same decay. With standard high-speed digital materials, typically your decay value changes slightly if you go to a different construction.
What is the predictability, Alex? Instead, you know, talking about this material, how tightly do you specify the main specifications?
Yep. So the decay, for example, would be with a tolerance of plus minus 0.005. which is pretty low. Yeah. And this is listed according to IPCC 4103. I think it's /17. So it's actually controlled. The decay is controlled for manufacturing lots, and there's a way in getting a report on that, if that's needed. So, but before we jump to the RF materials, let me point out two more categories. First of all, there's the tachyon material family. This is the lowest loss material that is currently on the market. Also in very many different core thicknesses and pre-preg thicknesses. So you have all degrees of freedom with ultra low loss. And one thing that's important, and that's true for the tachyon and also for iTerra and also for 48HR, it's not only the nice dielectric with a low DF value, but we actually offer a special copper type, which is called the ultra smooth copper type. Uh-huh. And you being you know that rough copper, there's something called skin effect.
Exactly.
So the higher you go in frequency, the copper roughness is hurting your loss quite a bit. So you have the best possible DF value, and then you have a lousy copper.
Okay.
Doesn't make sense.
So we are designing a fine PCB with a very good, well-known epsilon R factor, and we mess up with our copper, and we still get nowhere. That's your solution.
And that's why we have, first of all, the low DF values, but we also have on top the very smooth copper foil, so we can handle both.
Yep.
And then chronon is a little bit a different story. If you talk about differential signals, you have what's called fiber weave effect. You have glass reinforcement, and so the differential pair, the propagation speed may be a little bit different, which makes a lot of difficulties in differential signals.
Phase shift and so on.
Yes. So this material was specially engineered to get rid of that differences in local difference in decay value. Now, coming to the microwave materials, we have that long list of IS680 materials. This is material that's basically targeted for double-sided requirements. Mm-hmm. And it comes at different decays, as low as 2.8, as high as 3.45. And you can pick between a lot of different decay values. You can see the DF value is also very low. So this is really an ultra-low loss material.
Yep.
And then we already touched briefly the iTerra MTRF, which is very similar to the iTerra MT, ultra low loss, available in three different decay values, available as a core. If a multilayer construction is needed, or you want to combine that with a standard F4 part, for cost reduction reasons, you may want to put the digital part on your antenna part, you can use either that iTerra prepreg here or any of the prepregs here and combine them. So you can make nice little hybrid construction. This is another material that's really interesting one. That's the Astra MT. This is a material that's tailored to replace PTFE type of products. So very low loss decay free, very low dissipation factor of 0.0017, and ultra smooth copper. And now I can show you this is a... Can I hand you a microphone for a second? Thanks. this is really a nice story. Mm-hmm. This was a 77 gigahertz automotive radar sensor.
Yeah.
And what was done here is, this is based on a Freescale chipset.
Mm-hmm.
This was done in cooperation with Freescale and RF Beam as a design house.
Yeah.
And we used a design that was intended for PDFE materials. And we just pulled out a PDFE and put in our Astra material without any changes in the design.
Mm-hmm.
So nobody had to deal with adopting the design to the new material.
So
just replaced one material to another, and it worked. And
did you actually insert it like here, Alex? Is that correct? Your PCB?
Yeah. The Astra is actually
you
twice
just opened
in that construction.
It up and
it basically, you can open this metal pieces, you can take out this antenna portion, which is a double-sided Astra core, and put another one in and clamp it together. And then you can just start running the radar module, and if we would have set it up here, you could see if I move to the radar sensor, you would pick up the object moving towards the sensor and moving away from the sensor.
Did you actually notice an improvement in the performance of the radar due to this PCB? Longer range or more accurately defined response?
The improvement was not so much tailored for larger range or higher sensitivity, what happened here is PTFE is known to being a very difficult material to manufacture in a PCB environment. You need plasma processes. Yeah, okay. You have difficulties getting the copper adhesion to a material. PTFE, that's what you have in your pants, in your kitchen. It's a non-stick material. So how do you get copper sticking to that? So using that Astra material, we actually got rid of all these manufacturing issues.
Brilliant.
It's easy to manufacture. Yeah. It can be combined with prepregs. You can build hybrids. So you may have seen that's actually now three PCBs. We have a standard PCB. I.O. board, we have a MMIC board and the antenna. As a matter of fact, going forward, people may decide that they want to combine these three PCBs into one because it's just now so easy to have everything
in
one.
You just told us because it's possible now to integrate materials in a single PCB.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So and just to wrapping up, there are some other materials group like low flow prepreg that's used for special applications. Yeah. And we also have what we call specialty products. That's mainly polyimide products. Mm-hmm. I would say we have a lot of people around the globe then are able to help customers in deciding if they need something on that. Mm-hmm. So I would recommend getting in contact with Isola folks if more information is needed for that. For today, I just wanted to basically focus on the high-speed digital section where you can see we have a huge line of different materials that accommodate every need. And we have, for the microwave RF section, we have a set of new materials that can compete with standard PTFE materials that were used in industry or hydrocarbon-based materials, but at a lower cost of material, lower cost of manufacturing, easier to manufacture. So that's really the value add to the industry.
Yep. Alex, one final question from a technological point of view. Designers, when they want to start designing like a radiating PCB can they get from you all the specific epsilon R factors as digital to enable them to design PCBs? Can that be integrated in the, because this show is all about production and design, of course, also production. Can designers get all these values from you like in a digital format?
Yeah, sure. My background is actually high-frequency electric engineering, so I was in need of these factors before I joined Isola all
absolutely.
The time. So the good thing is that I can say, yes, we have all of that available. Obviously, we are not putting it out on an open website everybody,
but customers
can apply for a login, and then you can have a very detailed DKEDF table, so you have all the construction, all different thicknesses with the DKEDF values at different frequencies, going from less than 1 gigahertz up to 20 gigahertz for that range, typically 10 gigahertz for that range, so that is all available.
Okay.
And on top of that, we even supplied that data to, for example, some simulation tool providers, so they can have it in a database, so people using these simulation products can actually just do a drag and drop of materials in that system and have all the DKEDF values already included.
It saves a hell of a lot of time with experimenting and tuning and filing as we used
to do in the old days. And probably even more important, it avoids mistakes.
Yes.
Just writing mistakes, taking a value from here to a system and just adding another zero or omitting one.
Okay. Alex, thank you very much for your presentation on the Isola products. And I'm a radio amateur myself. It used to be called black magic, what we are doing with SHF, you know, with filing and tuning and microwave stuff. And this seems to be a good method to keep that in check and in control, and so know what you're talking about.
Yes.
Well ahead of trying to find the fault in a circuit and spending many, many hours on debugging. That's not the right word for RF, but testing and optimizing. Thank you very much for the interview.
Yep. Thank you for giving me the time to show you materials. And
thank you, Alex.
Have a good day. Thanks.
Thank you. We've done a lot of visits here at Productronica 2015. Extremely nice people to talk to. A very informative, deeply technical. We try to cover deeply technical rather than marketing blah, blah for this installment of Electro Business TV. The best expert so far was Alex, as you may have noticed from his explanations on new technologies for printed circuit board materials. It's Jan Buiting reporting from Productronica 2015, and thanks to cameraman Patrick.